Allah, there's only one God and Muhammad is his messenger. Allah, la ilaha illallah.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma baad, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbish rahali sadri wa yassirli amri wa halul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. I'd like to welcome you all this evening by saying assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are going to talk about one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Last week, if you remember, we talked about the life of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And today we are going to talk about the second Khalifa of Islam, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. It was the year 638. Jerusalem had been handed over to the Muslims in a bloodless conquest. And a peace treaty needed to be signed between the Muslims and the Jews and Christians in Jerusalem at that time. And they had demanded that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who was the Khalifa of the time, come and personally sign that peace treaty. And naturally, when a place has been conquered and a place has been handed over, and a place as special as Jerusalem, which has significance for people all over the world, be they Muslims, Jews or Christians, any place that has been conquered, the rulers, when they march into that land, they normally come with hundreds of thousands of troops, people playing music, lot of pomp and glitter, caravans of camels and horses and you name it. Because it's a happy moment. And for any ruler to come into a new territory which he has just conquered, it is an amazing time and a very joyous occasion. So naturally, a lot of these rulers, when they come into this new territory, they come with a lot of hue and cry. But how did this Khalifa of Islam conquer Jerusalem? He came not with 1,000 men or 1,000 camels, not with 100 men or 100 camels. He walked in with 1 camel, 1 slave, and the slave riding on top of the camel and the ruler walking along with him. This is the Khalifa of the Muslimin, the Amirul Mu'mineen, Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. This is the character of that man. And when he walked into Jerusalem, it was not a problem for those people to hand over the keys to this just and fair ruler, who could treat his own slave like this. It was not a problem for them to hand over the keys to Jerusalem to this man. And previously, while he was on his way towards Jerusalem, he was stopped by one of his generals, Abu Ubaidah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who literally stopped him and said that, Amirul Mu'mineen, it will not suit the Muslims that their Khalifa is going in this condition, with clothes that have patches on them, raggedy clothes. And especially when he saw him putting his socks on top of his shoulders and taking his camel for a drink. He said it will not give us izzah to the Muslims to see that the Amirul Mu'mineen is going to meet the non-Muslims in this state. And what did this man have to say? He said, I did not expect you to say these words. You of all people to say this? He said, no. He told him, we before Islam were the lowest of the low, but Allah gave us izzah through Islam. Because of Islam, we have the izzah in the world that we have today. And believe me, this is such an important lesson for all of the Muslims across the world. If you think that you will ever get even an ounce of respect in this dunya, it will only be through Islam. Only through Islam, not by any other means. If you are true to Islam, you will get izzah, respect in the eyes of the believers and disbelievers. But if you are not true to Islam, then you've got problems. Then there is no izzah for you. Such is the character of the second Khalifa and the companion of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Umar radiyallahu anhu. The question to ponder over is, why do we study about such people? It is, the main reason is that we need to look at people who are far better than us. We have to aim high so that even if we fall short, we are still those who are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because these are those people who to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with Allah. Allah ta'ala gave them this blessing in the Holy Quran. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them the good news of Jannah during their own lifetimes. So you cannot go wrong in following these people. If we try to imitate them or emulate our lives according to their way of living, inshallah we have found success. Believe me. They were the best of mankind. And they were given the promise of Jannah. The promise of Jannah. It was guaranteed for them. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Masood radiallahu anhu narrates that whoever needs to follow someone, then follow those who have passed away. Because the lives are not safe from trials. And this is what he said to the Tabi'een, that do not follow us who are alive right now, because we still have a long way to go. Maybe we'll make a mistake, and maybe some of us might not be very good Muslims by the time we die. So he told the Tabi'een, also one of those who were promised by the Holy Prophet ﷺ, that these are the three best generations. The generation of the Holy Prophet ﷺ, the ones after him, and the ones after him. So this is again a very important lesson for us to look at the lives of those who have passed away, because we know from beginning to end how they lived their lives. Were they obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Were they those people who were beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And it is easy for us to judge. But if a person is alive now, we don't know whether or not tomorrow this person will be a believer of Allah or not. So likewise, we have chosen for our today's talk one of the greatest legends of Islam, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. Speaking about his physical description, he was a tall man, so tall in fact that it is narrated that when he used to walk with a group of people, it used to seem like he is the one riding on a horse and everybody else is walking. He was extremely powerfully built, and he grew up and was raised by his father very harshly. He was initially a shepherd, and he was also a champion wrestler. No man could touch him. He was also very learned and very knowledgeable. He also used to be a sort of a bully before getting into Islam. He was someone who was feared by all. And the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that the best of them in the times of Jahiliyyah become the best of them after accepting Islam. And this was the story of Hazrat Umar as well. He was so stern and so fierce and so firm on the deen after he came to Islam that people used to really fear him and fear his judgment. You see, the Holy Prophet ﷺ kept two people very close to him, Abu Bakr Siddiq and Umar radiallahu anhu. And one of them was the gentle and mild one, the compassionate one. That was Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And then there was the stern one, the one who did not bend or budge from the Sharia, and that was Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu. And so stern was he that once it is reported that he was walking with one of his companions and there was a pregnant woman walking behind these two gentlemen. And when Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu turned back to look who was behind them, the pregnant woman miscarried just by one look of Sayyidina Umar. This is how stern he was and how much fear people had of him. Although you will find out later that what a soft heart he had and how he used to weep in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was given the title of Al-Faruq, the one who can judge between right and wrong, the one who can judge between haq and batil, the one who can judge between truth and falsehood. This is what is the meaning of Al-Faruq, because he could differentiate very clearly that this is the haq and this is the falsehood. He was known as Amirul Mu'mineen, and this was the first time that this term was ever used. He was the shepherd who grew up to be the leader of the Muslims, shepherd in a very small land of a very small herd of sheep, and he became the leader of the Muslimin from the corners of Persia to the Middle East to North Africa. This is the story of Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu.